You are God. Sustained us. You have made us what we are. We return the glory to you this morning. We ask that your name be glorified. Let nobody as in your presence today go back the same. Let no man or woman watching online go back the same. Let everybody be blessed both by your word and by the communion today. We thank you for all that you are set to do. In Jesus' precious name we have prayed. Amen. And somebody say a big amen. Amen. Help me wave to your neighbor, say welcome to the presence of God. Amen. Genesis chapter 37, verse 5 to 9. Genesis 37, 5 to 9. You are all looking good on that mask. Amen. Please make sure you always wear your mask when you are in church. If you can. But if you cannot, God will help us. Genesis 37, verse 5. And Joseph dreamed a dream. And he told it to his brethren, and they hated him yet the more. And he said to them, hear, I pray you, this dream which I have dreamed. For behold, we were binding sheaves in the field, and lo, my sheave arose and also stood upright, and behold, your sheaves stood round about and made obeisance to my sheep. And his brethren said to him, shall thou indeed reign over us, or shall thou indeed have dominion over us? And they hated him yet the more for his dreams and for his word. May the Lord not allow us to be surrounded by haters of our dreams. Yeah. I thought I would hear another amen. Yeah. There are people that don't want to see your dream become a reality. May God not surround you with such people. Yeah. In 2021, may God weed out every dream killer around you. Amen. Every hater of your destiny. Yeah. Everybody that want to say, no, we cannot see you rise to the top. May the Lord weed them away in the name of Jesus. May the wind of the Holy Ghost blow away unfriendly friends. People that pretend to be your friends, but they are not your friends. Secretly, they are hating on you. Secretly, they are talking against you. Secretly, they are conspiring against you. May the wind of the Holy Ghost blow them away. And if you believe that, shout a louder amen. Verse number 9, and I love this one. And he dreamed yet another dream. Look at your neighbor, say dream again. Dream again. In spite of the hate. Oh, come on, help me preach now. Say dream again.
Dream again.
In spite of the hate.
In spite of the hate.
Dream again.
Dream again.
No matter what they say. Dream again. Even if they left you. Dream again. They abandoned you. Dream again. They said you cannot make it. Dream again. They said you were a failure. What do you do?
Dream again.
Dream again. They said you can't rise to the top. What do you do?
Dream again.
They said without me you cannot make it. What do you do?
Dream again.
Somebody shout dream again.
Dream again.
Say, I shall dream again.
I shall dream again.
Bible says, and he dreamed yet another dream. The Bible is complete. I love the word of God. While they were hating on him, he dreamed another dream. I don't know who I'm talking to this morning, but somebody needs to dream again. in 2021. That dream that looked like it died in 2020, you must dream again. You are coming back with it, and this time around, you shall achieve it. I say you shall achieve it in the name of Jesus. And he told his brethren again and said, behold, I have a dream, one more dream. And behold, the sun and the moon and the 11 stars made obeisance to me. My God. Joseph was not afraid to share his dreams. And while they were hating him, he was still dreaming. I want you to understand that until you give up, God does not give up on you. You see, God does not consult human beings to bless you. If he does, many of us won't be where we are today. God does not go to people, Pastor Dapo, to ask for permission. Should I bless him or not? No, he doesn't. Pastor Dave, if God consulted people to bless you or to decide whether you'll be alive or not, maybe you'll be gone by now. Some people that don't like your face will say, well, let him go. But God does not consult. So you must keep dreaming. Because the extent of your destiny depends on how far you can dream. How far you can dream. Whatever you say is possible, God says amen to it. Your limitations in life is a function of the limitations of your mind. If your mind says, I can't do it, your whole body will shut down and agree with you. But if your mind says, it is possible, everything around you will begin to jump up and say, yes, it can happen. Somebody abandoned you and said, without me, you can't succeed. Show them that it takes only God for you to succeed. Somebody say a big amen. Amen. There are many people that sometimes they think that they are God to you. But God shows them that he is above all. The King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And in 2021, my God will surprise you. Amen. He will put jubilation in your mouth. Your family shall be celebrated. Amen. If you believe that, say loud amen. Amen. Now, Joseph had a dream. And when he shared it with his brethren, the Bible said they hated him. There are dreams you have that make people uncomfortable. But still keep dreaming. Amen. Keep dreaming. It is dreams that God put in your heart to make sure your destiny is fulfilled. I just want to talk briefly on five actions to prepare you for the new year. Five actions to prepare you for the new year. Every new year, people make resolutions. And I'm not one that believes so much in resolutions. Because I've seen people make resolutions and by January ending, they have broken all the resolutions. But I believe more in action steps to be taken to make sure that you achieve what you want to achieve. If you want 2021 to be different from 2020, there are certain things you must do compulsory. You cannot do things the way you did them in 2020 and expect the new year to be different. You can't. It's not possible. Even God himself came to Moses one day and said to Moses, you have dwelt too long on this mountain. Tell the children of Israel to move forward. Take a step. So I'm going to be running through a few things that I believe will help you if you want to see your dreams in 2021 come to pass. Amen. Somebody say big amen. Amen. Number one, wait upon God. waiting upon God for direction is number one key for destiny fulfillment. Waiting upon God. What did I say? Waiting upon God. Can we say it together? Waiting upon God. In Isaiah chapter 40 verse 30 to 31, the Bible says, even the youth shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly fall. But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Somebody say a big amen. Amen. In Psalm 27 verse 14, the Bible says, wait upon the Lord. Be of good courage, and he shall strengthen your heart. Wait, I say, upon the Lord. And in Psalm chapter 62 verse 5, the Bible said, my soul, wait thou only upon God, for my expectations are from him. They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. As the year passes by, your strength is getting weary. The devil tried to weary you. The devil tries to bring you down. But when you wait upon the Lord, your strength is renewed. Every year, you must make out time to wait on God. Thank God the church has a waiting time starting from tomorrow. It's a time to wait. It's a time to get direction. It's a time to seek the face of God. It's a time to say, God, look, don't take anything for granted. Some people say, why must you pray for the new year? There's a reason for that. There's a reason. Don't joke with it. Even God celebrates New Year's. God celebrates firstborns. God celebrates first fruit. There are certain ceremonies God celebrates. Jesus told us concerning the communion. There are certain things, say, as long as you do this, there are certain things that becomes a pattern in the life of a believer that helps you to build your spiritual man. So every year, take out time. Take it serious. Go to God in prayer. And say, Lord, I usually go to hotels before the end of the year. But this year I couldn't make it because hotels were closed. So in our house, for the first time, I was praying with my wife. We prayed together. You know, talking to God concerning the year. Because it's important to set the pace. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Somebody once said that in a marathon race, the person that starts the race will determine how it ends. If in your team, the person that starts the race does not run enough to hand over the baton to the next person, slows down your team, there is every likelihood you will come last. So that means that how you start a thing is important. Very important. If you must end it well, if in December 2021 you will have testimonies, start it well with God.
Amen.
Wait upon the Lord. When we say pray. Go to God in direction. For direction. God, what do you want me to do this year? Where are you taking me to in terms of my spiritual life this year? Where are you taking my family to this year? What do you want me to accomplish in my life this year? You don't have to be a pastor to set an agenda for your spiritual life. You can say, Lord, I used to pray for 30 minutes. Can I increase it to 45? Can I increase it to 1 hour? You can say, Lord, there are people in my family that are not yet saved. In 2021, Lord, can I bring them to join the fold of Christ? There are things you can do. You can say, Lord, I've been saving money for some time. Can I start a business this year? If the Lord says yes, you can ask, what kind of business do I start? Direction from God. And as you do that, whatever you do with God is bound to prosper. Somebody say a big amen.
Amen.
Lord, I've been saving money. And I've been talking about buying a house. Lord, I want to buy a house this year. Give me instruction. What direction do I go? A lot of people have become billionaires because they heard from God what to do. I once heard the story of a woman in Nigeria that started what we call pure water business in Nigeria. Some of you may not understand, but it was something. She was a graduate. She had a PhD and she was looking for a job, no job anywhere. I had this testimony on the altar of our spiritual father, Bishop Oyedepo, who is a mentor to my mentor. And the woman was sharing the testimony that one day Bishop Oyedepo told all of them to stand up. If you are not employed in this church and you have a certificate, you are a graduate, stand up. And everybody, they were so happy. Papa wants to pray for us. Everybody stood up. You know, when Bishop says stand up, that means something is about to happen. He looked at all of them, so many of them, hundreds of them standing up. His church is one of the largest in the world. And he looked at every member of the congregation and he said, all of you that are sitting there, look at them and say, shame on you. And everybody said, shame on you. And he looked at them, he said, do you know why I say shame on you? He said, you are not using your head. He said, how can you have certificates? You are a graduate and you are looking for somebody to employ you. Come on, go out there and create employment. The woman said that word provoked her. You know, some churches, some people walk away. But you know, there are certain things that are done spiritually with spiritual implications. Yeah. Hallelujah. Amen. There are certain things. I once told somebody that if it were in certain churches that Jesus called Peter, Satan, get thee behind me, Peter would have left the fold and said, I'm no longer an apostle. I'm no longer a disciple. There are certain words that are spoken in the spirit that have, it does not have physical impact, but there are spiritual message it carries. The woman said she was upset in her spirit. She said, Kai, Bishop has done this thing to us. We must change. Something must happen. She went home and said, God, give me an idea. I'm a graduate. I have PhD. How can I be carrying portfolio everywhere? And right there, that night, God gave her a dream. Because of that prophetic word. And she decided to start this business. Then nobody was talking about people. She started packaging this thing in a very beautiful way in the city of Lagos. It wasn't popular then. And that was how today is everywhere. But she was one of the people that pioneered it. She made millions and became a millionaire by virtue of selling water. Because God gave her an idea. And she was sharing the testimony. Today, she's one of the major sponsors in that ministry. When you talk about people bringing millions, she's one of them. Because somebody spoke into her life. God gave her direction. She waited upon the Lord. And there is somebody here right now. You are looking outside for help. But God is saying the help you need is inside of you. Amen. Somebody say a big amen. Amen. In 2021, some of you will walk into the realm of millions. Amen. Oh, I thought I would hear a louder amen. Amen. Shout a thunderous amen. In 2021, God will give you ideas that will alter your future, that will alter your destiny. Whatever you saw last year, God is going to do greater things in your life. Amen. Say loud amen. Amen. Number two, have a dream. Have a dream. Have a dream. Have a vision for where you are going. Where do you want to see yourself at the end of 2021? Start thinking about it now. Don't wait until the middle of the year. Set goals. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
You see, when you look at my diary, something I keep talking about, I wish I'll come to church with my diary one of these days. I've already planned the year till December. The ones I can. It's already there. You must have a dream like Joseph. Have a vision. Amen. Decide what you want to see. From, you know, we call God Alpha and what?
Omega.
I didn't hear you. Alpha and what?
Omega.
What is the meaning of Alpha and Omega?
Beginning,
beginning and end. We say he's the one that knows the end from the beginning. And you are his child.
Amen.
You carry his DNA. You can begin to talk about the end from the beginning. So you can sit down in January and say, God, in December, by the time we are in December, these are the things I want to see in my life. And because you're a child of God, and the Bible says, like we said during the night vigil, he called those things that be not. One of my favorite scriptures. He called those things that be not as though they were. He speaks them into existence. My God, hallelujah. My God. When we were watching something on television the other day, and they were doing a documentary on Cambridge. And I told my daughter, I said, don't you want to go to Cambridge? She said, yes. I said, check right there and there. Me, I don't like postponing things. I said, begin to check now. Do they do that course in Cambridge? She checked. She said, oh, no, they don't. They don't offer in Cambridge. She said, okay, check Oxford. She checked Oxford. Yeah, I said, okay, put Oxford as your number one choice. Amen. We are already in January. We are talking about next year. Are you understand what I'm talking about? So she has already written down Oxford, first choice. Oxford, first choice. That is the way it works. My wife came to me, I want to read law. I have always wanted to read law. As she was talking, I was on the computer. She didn't know what I was doing. Oh, I found a course. There is a university. Before we, that very week, we registered her. Some of you procrastinate. And in procrastinating, you don't fulfill your desire. Amen.
Amen.
You know, Archbishop Onibe used to say, you must perspire to acquire your desire, which you admire, and do not retire, but retire. Did you hear what I just said?
Amen.
Shall I repeat that again?
Yes.
You must perspire to acquire your desire, which you admire. And do not retire, but do what? Refire. Look at somebody, say refire. Come and say it again, refire. Perspire to acquire your desire, which you admire, and do not retire, but
refire.
When you refire, you will achieve.
Amen.
Stop procrastinating. Look at my daughter, Kamika. Before you know it, she registered. She said she was encouraged by my testimonies. Register the school. Some of you need to go back to school. Register now. Don't wait until December. Don't be dreaming it. I wish. Do you know there are some people, I wish I have killed them.
Yeah.
I wish. And they are wishing until December come. And I thought I would do this thing. Because you never. My God, we are getting there.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Dream. Have a dream. Have a vision of what you want to become. Begin to think of December in January. That is the secret of great men. Amen.
Amen.
While you are celebrating, I put down in the good seed, I think either the good seed or one of the books. No, it's the good seed. You will see it as we keep reading. That while I was renewing my children's contract for their phone, and I was telling her, what phone do you want? It was Pamela and Sharon. I was doing their contract renewal. Yeah, it would be them. And I said, which phone do you want? All of them were asking for iPhone 11. My own phone was iPhone 10. In fact, it's still iPhone 10 up to now. Brother Archie. Amen. They were asking for iPhone 11. We went for iPhone 11. Amen. All of them have better phone than me now. But do you know why I'm sharing this testimony? Why we were celebrating iPhone 11, iPhone 12 came out. And those who are celebrating iPhone 12 now, Apple is planning for you, whether you like it or not. If you don't plan for yourself, they plan for you. Somebody said, if you don't have a dream for yourself, you'll be fulfilling somebody else's dream. That is true. Apple is planning for you now as we are talking. Mark what I'm telling you, by the middle of the year now, Apple have launched another iPhone. Maybe iPhone 13, I don't know. And they will give you one small excuse why you should buy it. Why it is better than the one you are using. They'll start telling you how the camera is bigger than the other one. Why? Why you are thinking about January, they are thinking of December. That's what makes them better. I told you, I said, if you want to be better than the best, think about what the best is doing and do it better. Great men are great men because they think ahead of other people. Amen. I don't understand what I'm saying. Yeah. Great men, hear me and hear me well, are where they are because they are thinking about you, more about you, better than you. Leaders are leaders because they think higher. They think ahead. You are here thinking about what you will eat today. Boris Johnson is already planning for 2025. Both have to win the election. They are planning. That's what makes them great. Think ahead. Let your mentality change. Let the way you think alter. Don't think for just the now. That's why I tell people, when you are asking God to bless you, don't ask God to bless you for just the now. If your dream is about how you will eat food in January, oh, sorry for you. That means you are living for self. But when you, there are some people as I'm talking now, they are thinking, do you know it was yesterday, the first I was asking my wife, I said, you have worked for the government. Tell me how the government works. She's there. She will tell you. She started telling me, I said, this year, we will register a company, we will bid for contracts. She's here. I'm giving you secrets.
Amen.
Yeah, supposed to be my secret, but I'm telling you, you can do it as well. I said, we will register for a company, we will bid for contracts in those local authorities. She worked with them, she knows how it works, she knows how to get the contract. There are people bidding, that, do you know that people that build these roads, they bid for contracts, they win, the government give them money to execute it, and some millions enter into their accounts. And you and I, we are there. There are things happening. Get involved. Get a dream in that your head. Let something come out of it. Don't just carry a big head like my own. You're walking around the whole place, and you don't. Nothing is coming out of it. Let something come out this year.
Amen.
Let God give you an idea that will affect and impact your family. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
You are not here to look at the beautiful buildings of England. You are here to make impact. Make impact in the life of people. Make impact in the life of your family. Make impact in your generation. Make impact in your nation. May the Lord give you wisdom to make impact this year.
Amen.
If you believe that, shout a loud amen.
Amen.
So you must dream. Have a vision. And even when the vision you tried, it didn't work, dream again. Like Joseph. Dream again. Don't give up. Look at the neighbor and say, don't give up.
Don't give
Help
up.
Me preach to your neighbor and say, don't give up.
Don't give up.
Dream again. Last year you tried, it didn't work. You wanted to buy a house, it didn't work. Dream again. You must buy this year. Don't give up. That it didn't work last year does not mean it won't work this year.
Amen.
Amen. I always said Elijah prayed for rain to fall. He didn't pray one time. Many believers will pray and say, God, well, I've prayed. It didn't work. They'll give up. He prayed the second time. It didn't work. He prayed the third time. God was telling us something. They wrote it down for a reason in the Bible. Everything written in the Bible is for a reason. It's for a reason. For you to be encouraged. For you to be steered up. For you to be inspired. He prayed the fourth time. Nothing happened. Fifth time, it didn't happen. Keep trying. As long as God is telling you to keep trying, keep trying. Except God tells you that is not my plan. But if God says keep trying, keep trying. Amen.
Amen.
And one day, it will be your turn to smile.
Amen.
Number three. Plan to succeed. Somebody say plan.
Plan.
Somebody once said that he that fails to plan, plans to fail. If you fail to plan, you plan to fail. So you have a dream, you have a vision, you are waiting on God, set out a plan. What plan do you have to accomplish your dreams? Having a dream without a plan is frustrating. Very frustrating. You cannot have a dream and you don't have a plan of how to accomplish that dream. You must have a plan. You must have what is called long-term plan and short-term plans of how you will accomplish what God is placing in your mind. I just gave you a clean example now. This year, I want to bid for contracts. I want to make some money. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
What is my short-term plan? My long-term plan is I want to make money. But my short-term plan is I want to register a company. Do you understand what I'm talking about?
Amen.
So you must have a short-term plan and then a long-term plan. By the end of 2021, this is what I want to see. But now in January, what can I do to see that in 2020, in December? So you have a short-term plan to accomplish your vision. Then you have a long-term plan that you work with to accomplish your vision. If you do that, you are guaranteed to see results. The reason we don't see results is that we believers do this a lot. We claim too much. Father, I claim it. I'm a billionaire. Billions will not fall on your laps. Somebody say, I hear. Billions will never. God is not a magician. Billions will never fall on your lap. You must have a vision of how to accomplish it. You must have a plan. Number four, believe you can do it. Is somebody there with me?
Amen.
Believe that you can do it. Somebody say a big amen.
Amen.
For number two, you can write Proverbs chapter 29, verse 18. It says, where there is no vision, the people perish. For number three, you can write Luke chapter 14, verse 27 to 30. It said, when you want to build a house, you have to sit down first and plan and find out whether you can accomplish what you are planning to do. There are scriptures to back them up. For number four, it said, believe in yourself that you can do it. David believed that he can defeat Goliath. Jesus said, believe in God, believe also in me. Self-belief is important. One of the greatest destructive power of the enemy is the ability to make people to not believe in themselves. If you don't believe you can do it, who else can believe that you can do it? Somebody once said the greatest tragedy of a human being is to have so much talent and not know you have it. So much talent. Amen. You know, I remember one day I told you a story. Myself and Reverend Thunderbolt, my friend, we went for a beauty, not a beauty contest, but an award ceremony. One of our spiritual fathers from Nigeria came, they were giving him an award. He's an architect, he's done great things for the country. So United Nations were recognizing him. And so the award was organized in one of the top hotels in central London. And we went to back him up. When we got there, they introduced a young lady, and said, this is Miss Social and So of a country. I think it was Miss Gambia or Miss something. Myself and Tunda looked at each other and we started laughing. We were like, is this the most beautiful girl in that country? But that was a message. It meant a lot. When they introduced her, because she came, so she was one of the guests of honor. So they said, they were introducing everybody, and they said, now we want to introduce Miss so and so of this country. When she stood up, we were like, that means every girl in that country must be ugly. But anyway, it was a joke, you know, boys joke. But let me tell you something. Now let me tell you something about that. Why did we make that joke? Because in beauty contests, it is only those that appear that they regard.
Yes.
Do you understand what I'm saying? Now that does not, if you see Miss England, you even say your sister is more beautiful. You understand what I'm talking about? Miss England may not be the most beautiful girl in the whole of England, but it is those that show up. Among those that show up, that do not choose. Somebody say a big amen.
Amen.
So it is because they believe in themselves, they came out. And so because they believe in themselves, well, if nobody's coming out to show their behavior, I will come out. So you are there saying, what do you think? Who do you think you are? You are there. It's like football. Do you know that there are footballers that are better than Sterling and mention their names, but nobody knows about them because they don't believe in themselves. They have not showed their talents. Believe in yourself. If you believe in yourself, then the world will discover you. If you don't believe in yourself, you will hide your talents. Many of us are hiding our talent. There are people that can sing, but nobody knows them like Sinach. But the day Sinach came out, the whole world celebrated her. But I'm sure she was somewhere struggling in one village or one town or one city that nobody knew. Until the day she came out and said, here I am, I can sing. Today the whole world is celebrating her. Don't hide your talent. Look at your neighbor and say, don't hide your talent. Every man, every woman has something that God has placed in them that can expose them to their generation. That can make you something. Everybody has it, even in this church. You have something that you can be celebrated for. Why are you hiding it? Why are you hiding it? Your talent. Bring out what God has placed in you. Make use of it. It is part of what makes life exciting. Don't hide what God has placed in you. Be proud of who you are. Somebody say amen. Amen. Be proud of what God has made you. I have a daughter in the Lord. When I was in the law school, I was the president of the Christian Law Students Fellowship. She was my music director. She was the fattest girl in our fellowship. But she was my music director. Guess what? When she left university, she started a show on television called Le Pachos Bosse. She became celebrated. She used her fat to advertise herself. She was so big that everybody wanted to see her. Are you understand what I'm saying? If you type that word I just mentioned now, you will see her. She was instead, people started inviting her for events everywhere. She made more money from that than being a lawyer. Because she celebrated herself. Even though I'm told now she has gone to reduce her weight. I have another boy, not connected to me nowhere. I went to the airport one day, and as I was entering the plane, I saw a vehicle, escorts, bringing a young boy to enter the plane. Some of us were queuing, but people escorted him to come and enter the plane. When they opened the door for him, I was looking for him, I couldn't find him. I looked down, it was Aki and Popo. Some of you may not understand what I'm talking about. In Nollywood, they are the shortest boys. I don't know if, how many of you watch Nigerian movies? The shortest of the shortest. You can, if you look like, just look, you don't need to look up. Just look, you won't find them. But they are celebrated because they celebrate themselves. They use what people may call disability and became an ability. And today they are celebrated. Believe in yourself. You are not born without talent. Find out what God made you for. Find out something. If you are making hair, make it in such a way that you can draw the skies in heaven on somebody's head. Are you understand what I'm saying? If you are cooking jollof rice, my God, cook it that somebody will come and ask for a second plate. If you are making coffee, coffee it in such a way that when they finish drinking, they'll take some home. There's a talent in you you can sell. Don't look at yourself and say, oh, I'm no good. There's nothing good about me. No, there is something good about you. There's something. That's why I always say that my favorite song, I don't know whether it's a Christian song or not, I don't know who wrote it. I believe in angels. Something good in everything I see. I believe in angels. Before I look for the evil in somebody, I first look for the good. My wife knows me for that. That's why I hardly find evil in people. I have no enemies. I always want to see something good in somebody. Amen. Because child of God, if you want to see something bad in somebody, you will find it. Amen. So my principle in life, I always look for the good. When I meet you for the first time, I first search for the good part of you. And I try to ignore the bad part of you. Somebody say big amen. Amen. Look at your neighbor and say, I believe in myself. And I shall fulfill destiny. In the mighty name of Jesus. Finally, and the last one before we go to the communion, take steps to fulfill your dreams. Take steps to fulfill your dream. The Bible says in James chapter 2, verse 26, for as the body without the spirit is dead, so faith without work is dead. You must take steps if your dreams must become a reality. You must take steps. You must take steps. Don't allow your dream die inside of you. There is greatness in you. There is something waiting to be made manifest. The Bible said, they that do know their God shall be strong. and they shall do exploit. Take steps as you dream, as that vision is coming, as you are waiting on God, begin to take practical steps. That God, in December, I want to be in year one or year two of this study. Take steps to register in the university. Don't wait. God, I want to buy a house by the end of December. Take steps to open an account and call it building account. I understand what I'm talking about. Now, God, I want to make some money in this direction. Ask God, how do I make that money? How do I make that money? Somebody called me 2 days ago. He said, I have an idea and I want to copyright it. How do I copyright it before I sell it to the public? He said, represent me and I'll pay you. And we are looking for how to copyright that idea. Take steps. There are ideas. There are things. Encourage your children to be thinkers. Don't restrict them. Don't restrict the way they imagine. Don't restrict their mathematical ability. Don't restrict their scientific explorations. As long as they are within the Lord. Make them to be thinking. Make them to think wide. Don't make them think everything is religion. There is something that they can do that they will be an impact to their generation. That the world will be looking for them. Think. Use your brain. Use your mind. Let your mind, let your imagination run wild. Think about what you can do. Sit down this January and say, Lord, before the end of December, what can I do that will benefit the kingdom? How can I make it for you? Somebody said the sword of Gideon and the sword of the Lord. How can I make it for you to benefit the church and benefit my generation? If God sees how determined you are, he will give you ideas. There are still plenty of things yet to be seen. I was reading a book some few days ago, and they were saying, no, it was not a book, it was BBC. They said, the universe, the end of the universe has not yet been discovered. As wise as scientists are, as powerful as science is, the scientists don't know the end of the universe yet. Nobody has seen it. That is the mightiness of God. God is so mighty that we can only say, oh, there are galaxies. There are these. Nobody knows the breadth and the depth of the universe. Because God has kept that secret to himself. So that tells you that with God, all things are what? Possible. Bow down your heads in prayer. Thank you, Lord Jesus. 2020 must be beneficial for you. My days are filled with laughter. My heart has known your peace. I've traveled far, still there is more to go. But in my heart there is a longing to look upon your face. Where you are is where I long to be. You are my King. Basha. You are the Lion of Judah. You are the Seed of Abraham. The God has spoken concerning you. I want you to lay your hand either on your chest or on your head and say, Lord, reveal myself to me. Reveal myself to me. Show me the me inside of me that makes me what you want me to be. Show me, Lord, the inner me, what you have placed in me for my generation, both in ministry and in life. Maybe God wants you to be stronger. You want to be a better Christian this year. What steps are you taking to be a better Christian? Do you want to attend church more? Do you want to pay your tithes more? Do you want to pray more? Do you want to evangelize more? That is in the spiritual realm. what is it you want to do? You must make up your mind. Don't enter into 2021 lackadaisically, anyhow. Wherever the wind blows you, you blow. No, be deliberate. Be deliberate. Be deliberate. Be deliberate. God, I want to pray more this year. Lord, I want to serve you more this year. Lord, I want to know you more this year. Lord, I want to be closer to you more this year. Lord, I want to make more money this year. Lord, I want to return back to school this year. Lord, I want to open a business this year. Lord, I want to buy a house this year. Lord, I want to get married this year. Lord, what is it you are telling God? Be deliberate about it. If you are not deliberate, God will not follow you where you are going. God does not work with people that have no agenda. People that have no agenda, they just, as they, anywhere the wind blows them, that's where they go. No, God does not work with people like that. God works with people that have agenda, people that have a plan. If you have a plan, God will work with you. Thank you, King of Glory. We give you the praise. We magnify you. Thank you, Ancient of Days. Hallelujah. We bless you. Father, I pray for your children as they are meditating, as they are praying on you, on the vision they have for the year. I ask that you give them the ability to have faith. Give them the ability to believe in themselves. Give them the ability to believe they can make it. Give them the ability to believe they can achieve it. Give them the ability to believe that it is possible. Lord, also give them the ability to plan. To plan. Give them the ability to wait on you this year, Lord. We give you the praise and the glory. Thank you, King of Glory, for hearing our prayer. In Jesus' precious name we have prayed.
Amen.
And everybody say a big amen.
Amen.